Bagian berikut, section 4, reading. Read the text about people's hobbies. See the word box. Jadi, bacaan ini tentang hobi beberapa karakter yang ada di buku ini. Yang pertama, Galang loves fishing. He goes fishing once a week. He brings his fishing rod, a bucket, and a fishing net. Monita likes reading. She reads novels. She has more than 20 novels. Her favorite novel is Laskar Pelangi. She reads novels twice a week. Andre likes mobile gaming. He plays every weekend. He needs a smartphone and internet connection for mobile gaming. Ibu Posma and Sinta love playing badminton. They usually play badminton on Sunday morning. They need rackets and a shuttlecock to play badminton. Their favorite badminton player is Jonathan Christie. B. Work with a classmate to complete worksheet 1.15 based on the text 1.1. Jadi berdasarkan cerita tadi atau reading dari keempat gambar tadi, adik-adik identifikasi di table hobi, kemudian frekuensi. Frekuensi di sini seberapa sering mereka melakukan hobi tersebut, and then tools needed. Alat atau perlengkapan yang dibutuhkan. Yang pertama, Galang. Hobinya adalah fishing. Frekuensi, seberapa sering dia memancing? Once a week. And tools needed? Fishing rod, bucket, and fishing net. Kemudian Monita, hobi, reading. Frequency, twice a week. Tools needed, novels. And then Andre, hobby, is mobile gaming, frequency, every weekend. Tools needed, ya, smartphone and internet connection, ya. Nah, untuk Ibu Posma and Sinta, silakan adik-adik coba isi sendiri, ya. Tinggal diikuti hobinya apa, kemudian frekuensinya berapa kali seminggu, toolsnya, alat yang dibutuhkan untuk hobinya mereka apa. Oke, good luck. Nah, yang berikut ini adalah pertanyaan number one. Who loves playing badminton? Silahkan adik-adik coba cari jawabannya sendiri dahulu sebelum kakak jabarkan. Ya, Ibu Posma and Sinta. Jadi yang suka bermain badminton ini ya, Ibu Posma dan Sinta. Next, how often does Monita read novels? She reads novel twice a week. Nih ya, she reads novels twice a week. Next, what tools does Galang need to go fishing? He needs to bring a fishing rod, a bucket, and a fishing net. He brings his fishing rod, a bucket, and a fishing net. Number 4, mention the people who do their hobbies outdoors. Jadi, hobi yang di luar ruangan ya, ini siapa saja yang melakukannya. Ya, Galang Ibu Posma and Sinta. Jadi Galang kan ini ya, fishing, Ibu Posma and Sinta playing badminton. Sementara kalau mobile gaming dan reading ini bisa dilakukan di ini ya, indoors, di dalam rumah. Number 5, mention the hobbies that support physical health. Hobi yang bermanfaat untuk kesehatan secara fisik. Yes, badminton. Oke, seperti itu. Nah, yang bagian berikut, section 5, language focus. Coba adik-adik perhatikan di sini, Galang loves fishing. He brings his fishing rod, a bucket, and a fishing net. Nah, ini namanya pronoun. Pronoun ini adalah kata yang digunakan untuk mengganti noun. Contoh di sini Galang, di sini ada he. He ini mengganti kata Galang. Oke, okay, pronounnya Galang. Dan juga his. Nah, coba kita lihat di sini penjelasannya. Read Ibu Ida's explanations about pronouns. Words describing Galang are he and his. Jadi, kata-kata yang menggambarkan karakter Galang atau subjek Galang itu he dan his. Kata-kata ini disebut pronouns. He, his. A pronoun is used in place of a noun to avoid repetition. For example, you can see these words. Jadi, tujuan digunakannya pronoun ini untuk menghindari pengulangan, repetition ya. Misalnya, Galang loves fishing. He brings his fishing rod, a bucket, and fishing net. Nah, pengulangan di sini maksudnya seperti ini. Galang loves fishing. Bisa aja kita sebut lagi. Galang loves fishing. Galang brings Galang's fishing rod. Nah, itu kan pengulangan ya. Jadi, daripada kita sebut Galang kebanyakan, kita ganti kata yang di bawah ini, kata Galangnya menjadi he. Gitu ya. He brings his fishing rod. A pronoun can be singular or plural like this. Kata ganti itu bisa dalam bentuk tunggal ataupun jamak. I ini menjadi my. He, his. She, her. You, your. It ini sama, bentuknya it. Kalau plural, they menjadi their. We menjadi our. Kalau yang ini sebelah kiri artinya saya, dia laki-laki, dia perempuan, kamu, itu, mereka, kita. Kalau yang sebelah kanan ini artinya punya saya, punya dia, punya kamu, punya itu, punya mereka, punya kita. Oke? Semoga bisa dipahami ya. Nah, sekarang coba lihat teks yang ini. Underline pronouns referring to Monita, Andre, and Ibu Posma and Sinta. See the description of Galang's hobby in text 1.2 as an example. Jadi coba dikasih garis bawah di setiap kalimat-kalimat ini yang mana pronounnya. Yang pertama, Monita likes reading. She reads novels. Nah, berarti pronounnya di sini she. She has more than 20 novels. Her favorite novel is Laskar Pelangi. Andre likes mobile gaming. He does that every weekend. He needs a smartphone and internet connection for mobile gaming. Oke, jadi ini ya. He. Lalu yang berikut. Ibu Posma and Sinta love playing badminton. They. Nah, jadi they, mereka ini menggantikan kata atau subjek Ibu Posma and Sinta. They usually play badminton on Sunday morning. They, ini lagi, they need bla bla bla. Kemudian yang terakhir, their favorite badminton player is Jonathan Christie. Oke, jadi seperti itu ya. Nah, sekarang bagian 8, Pronouns-nya di sini ada singular and then plural. Singular, personal, ada I, she, he. Possessive pronoun, ya, possessive pronoun ini kalau untuk I, seperti yang ada di table sebelumnya, my. Nah, kalau she berarti her. He, his. Kemudian plural, ini posesifnya their, ya. Their, maka personalnya they. Yang berikut, complete the sentences with suitable pronouns. Pak Edo likes cycling. Blank goes cycling almost every morning. Blank bicycle is very expensive. Ya, di sini subjeknya Pak Edo, berarti selanjutnya ya kata ganti untuk Pak Edo. Jadi, he goes cycling. And then yang B, his bicycle is very expensive. Sepedanya sangat mahal. Number 2, Ibu Ida Ayu loves listening to music. Blank likes K-pop very much. Ya, pronounnya she. Blank favorite boy band is BTS. Ya, ini possessive pronoun ya. Her. Her favorite boy band is BTS. Next, Monita likes watching movies. Ya, coba adik-adik isi dahulu. Nomor 3 ini kira-kira apa? Ya, Monita likes watching movies. She loves watching K-drama. Her favorite actor is Hyun Bin. Nah, sekarang yang nomor 4, dijawab sendiri dahulu. Sinta and Tamara love playing badminton. They always play badminton on Sunday morning. They want to be a professional badminton players one day. Number 5, Pak Rahman Shah likes jogging. Blank jogs once a week. He jogs once a week. Blank jogs at the park on Sundays. Nah, ini dia butuh personal ya, butuh subjek yang seperti he, tidak his, karena ini ada kata kerja jogs at the park on Sundays. Jadi, tetap lagi, he. Ibu Komang's husband like photography. Blank, ya, he. Usually takes pictures using his smartphone. Okay, number 7, silahkan jawab sendiri dahulu. Monita and her father love hiking. They like to walk in the countryside. Their preferred hiking trail is Matang Kaladan Hill. Number 8. Yeah, Andre's mother likes cooking. Her soto banjar is very delicious. She wants to join the Master Chef competition one day. Okay, seperti itu ya. Section 6, your turn reading. Read the text about Pak Edo's hobby. Pak Edo's hobby. Pak Edo's hobby is cycling. He goes cycling every morning. Pak Edo always wears a helmet, a t-shirt, shorts, and shoes when he goes cycling. He never forgets to bring his bottle. Pak Edo sometimes goes cycling with his wife and children. They ride their bicycles together on weekends. Their favorite place for cycling is the park. They like cycling at the park because the air is very fresh. Pak Edo like cycling because it can make him healthy. Cycling makes immune cells more active. Cycling is also good for the environment because it doesn't release pollution. Nah, sekian readingnya. Coba kita lihat pertanyaannya di sini. Answer the questions on worksheet 1.19 based on the text. Where are Pak Edo and his family's favorite places for cycling? The park. Ini ada di paragraf 2 ya. Their favorite place for cycling is the park. Number 2. What day do Pak Edo and his family go cycling? Saturday and Sunday. Juga ada di paragraf kedua ya. They ride their bicycles together on weekends. Jadi weekends ini termasuk hari Sabtu dan hari Minggu. Next, they ride their bicycles together on weekends. What does the word they refer to? Pak Edo, his wife, and children. Kata they di kalimat they ride their bicycles together on weekends. Bagian ini ya, di paragrafnya. Kata they ini adalah pronoun atau kata ganti untuk Pak Edo, his wife, and the children. Next, do you agree with Pak Edo that cycling is useful for health and the environment? Explain. Yes, I agree. Cycling can make our bodies healthy and boost our immune system. Jadi ini adik-adik bisa jawab, bisa ikuti apa yang disampaikan di sini atau jawab dengan kata-kata sendiri ya. Ya, saya setuju, cycling can make our bodies healthy, bisa membuat tubuh sehat dan meningkatkan sistem imun. Why does Pak Edo wear his helmet whenever he goes cycling? For safety, demi keamanan. Pak Edo always wears a helmet, a t-shirt, short, dan seterusnya. Jadi, kita bisa simpulkan bahwa menggunakan helm ini untuk keamanan. Oke adik-adik, jadi demikian ya untuk unit 2 chapter 1. Thank you for watching.